more to come.
I see Zoom, but not gone.
Hey, I'm going to read this schedule.
Erroneous doth desire you to read at your best leisure. This his humble suit.
Read mine first, for mine's a suit that touches Caesar near.
What touches us ourselves shall be last served.
Blame not, Caesar, read it instantly.
What, is the fellow mad?
Sirrah, give place.
What, urgent positions in the street? Go to the Capitol.
I wish you were rested in your death.
When you rise from close,
here you will.
Say Publius Lena.
He wished our enterprise today might thrive. I feel our purpose at this hour.
How he makes to Caesar. Mark him.
Cassius, be silent, for we fear for vengeance. Brutus, what shall be done? If this be known, Cassius or Caesar shall never come back, for I will save myself.
Cassius, be constant. Publius Lena speaks out of our purposes. For look, he smiles, and Caesar doth not change.
Look, you Brutus. He draws Mark Antony out of the way.
Metellus Cimber, let him go and presently prefer his suit to Caesar.
He's addressed, press near and second him.
Casca, you are the first that rears your hand.
Are we all ready? What is now amiss that Caesar and his Senate must address?
My most mighty and most puissant Caesar, Metellus Cimber throws before thy seat an humble heart.
I must prevent thee, Cimber, these couchings and these lowly courtesies might fire the blood of ordinary men, and turn preordinance and first decree into the law of children. Be not fond to think that Caesar bears such rebel blood. I would be thawed from the true quality with that which melteth fools. I mean, sweet words, low crooked curtsies and base banning upon it. Thy brother by decree is banished. If thou dost bend and pray and fawn for him, I spurn thee like a cur out of my way. No, Caesar doth not wrong, nor without cause. Will he be satisfied?
Is there no voice more worthy than my own to sound more sweetly in great Caesar's ear for the repealing of my banished brother?
I kiss thy hand, but not in flattery, Caesar.
Desiring thee that Publius Cimber may have an immediate freedom of repeal.
What, Brutus?
Pardon, Caesar, Caesar, pardon, as low as to thy foot doth Cassius fall, to beg enfranchisement for Publius Cimber.
I could be well moved, if I were as you. If I could pray to move, prayers would move me. But I am as constant as the northern star, of whose true fixed and resting quality there is no fellow in the firmament. The skies are painted with the unnumbered sparks. They are all fire, and every one doth shine. There's but one in all doth hold his place. So in the world, 'tis furnished well with men, and men are flesh and blood, and apprehensive. Remember, I do know but one that unassailable holds on his rank, unshaped of motion, and that I am he. Let me a little show it, even in this, that I was constant Cimber should be banished, and constant do remain to keep himself. O Caesar! Hence, wilt thou lift up Olympus?
Great Caesar.
Doth not Brutus Bulus kneel?
Speak hands for me. Then fall, Caesar.
Liberty, freedom, tyranny is dead. Run hence, proclaim, cried about the streets.
some to the common pulpits and cry out, liberty, freedom, and enfranchisement.
People and senators, be not affrighted. Fly not, stand stiff, ambition's debt is paid.